In this 2021, we have today, during the quarantine, New York Dance and Innovation Quarantine Talk Series, we have outstanding Polish composer, pedagogue, and also percussionist, Marta Ptaszyńska. The composers who actually is based in the United States for so many years, but is originally from Poland, and who wrote so many different various pieces for orchestras, for the chamber wars, even operas, such a famous work like, for example, also the opera for children's in Poland, like Doremik recently, or also the Mr. Marimba, who was awarded in Poland, also here in the States, Guggenheim, and from Foundation. I was professor at the Chicago University for many, many years. And she is today with us. She is currently in Florida, and she will share with us her opinions, her reflection about the recent times, these difficult times of pandemic, about this eight last months. So hello, Professor. Thank you very much for being with us, and nice to see you.
Yeah, thank you very much, and hello, good afternoon, good evening, good day. Very nice to be in the program.
Thank you very much. So you are in Florida. Is it warm now or in Florida?
No,
or?
It's not. I am in Florida presently, but it's not very warm. It's actually, the weather, it's like early spring in Warsaw, in Poland. About this morning was 59, 58 degrees Fahrenheit.
Okay, so actually not so. Okay. So because I would like to ask you about this first question, about these difficult times, of the pandemic. This time you were in Florida. So how was it for your music? Did you find any inspirations? Was it difficult for you to compose? Because you sent recently, you had the premiere. We'll talk about this, your second flute concerto.
Yeah. So I will tell difficult? You about what I feel about. You know, as a composer, we always know that composers are working by themselves in isolation, by the piano or by at the desk, occasionally checking the music on the piano, but I don't like to have groups and people around me. So I really love the loneliness. So the pandemic just not influenced me that much. It was didn't have that much impact on my composition. And reverse, it actually gave me a lot of ideas and inspiration, because I have more time to sit at home and I have more time to compose right now. So this is the kind of thing that for me, actually, the pandemic just not changed my life, but reverse, encouraged to write my music. So I wrote a lot of pieces. I wrote the several pieces that I will never be able to write at the normal time. Mm. You know, this is the kind of thing, you know, I composed the concerto number one, that was the flute concerto for Łukasz Długosz, and supposed to be performed. This concerto number one for flute and orchestra supposed to be performed by the Cleveland Orchestra on April 5th with Łukasz Długosz, but this never happened because the Cleveland Orchestra actually canceled all concerts. Mm-hmm. And then, I wrote concerto number two for Agata and Olsztyn, and Olsztyn worked out. So it just, you never know how this worked.
It's a very short time you wrote concerto one and concerto two.
Immediately.
Right. So wow.
I think that it's actually this pandemic, it's very good for me, because actually I have more time to compose. So I wrote two concertos. Then I wrote a big piece, large in three movements, for the international marimba competition in Stuttgart. Mm. And that was supposed to be this is the piece for the third round of the concert of the competition. It is very demanding for marimba and three instruments. So the three instruments are clarinet, French horn and cello, and marimba. So it's the quartet. It is obligatory piece for the third round. But the competition didn't happen in September because they had to move to next year, but the piece is ready. And then I wrote the piece for the competition. Then I wrote, and then I am writing right now. Then I wrote the a concerto for accordion and orchestra.
Wow, orchestra, another concerto.
For the very famous and great, wonderful, wonderful accordion player. It's Claudius Baran, who is right now rector of the Chopin University of Music. So then I wrote the three concertos. Big piece for marimba, big but large and very demanding for the competition. And right now I am writing the piece for cello and piano for the Krakow duo, Schlezer Kalinowski.
Oh, I know.
Because they will have next year, this year.
Ah, this is 2021. We are talking about 2021.
They will have in spring, they will celebrate their 20th anniversary. So then I'm writing the piece for them, for this concert, for the festival in Krakow. So this is the music I wrote during this period of time.
Wow. It's incredible. So many pieces.
Yeah, this is just, you know, it's encouraging actually, because there is not too many things happening. Not too many. Almost nothing happens right now. Nothing. You know,
only virtual actually.
Mostly. Online. That was the conference, percussion conference, also the percussion conference in Poland before Christmas. And that was big participation of many composers. And I have the paper, you know, about my percussion music, which I sent you the catalog.
Yes, I got it.
So this is very productive time for me.
What do you think about the concerts online? Also about the virtual concerts, about online? What do you think about this?
Online concert, I have, you know, for me, it's fine, but it's still missing the body of the music, the sound, because the sound on my computer, for example, it's not good. So I hear, you know, like maybe of the spectrum of the sonority, I hear like half of the sonority. The top and bottom, it's always somewhere disappearing. It's in the middle only. So the thing is that the concerts are not really very good. Everybody is waiting. You know, how you can hear, for example, Beethoven symphony in live, very good hall, concert hall, and then you hear the same music in on computer, even in television, I think would be better. You know, the computer usually have this small possibility for sound, so they don't have this big, you know, huge, wonderful sound. Mm-hmm. So this is just like the substitute right
the
now.
The substitute. It is, but also the conferences that you mentioned, this percussionist conference, that was international. So how did you like it? How did it work? Was it on Zoom or maybe different platform?
That was on Zoom, right. Yeah, that was on Zoom. And also, you know, the Vonia Varsovia had in late of November, they had the concert also on Zoom only, online. Mm-hmm. And they play my Winter's Tale for the string orchestra.
Oh yes, it's a very famous piece. Yes,
conductor, you know, said that he fall in love with the piece, etc. And then I was sitting and listening, and I said, yes, probably that's true, but the sound in my computer, it's half of the sound here.
But professor, then if you are talking about this listening experience, I was always very fascinated when you had lectures in Krakow, and I got to know so many years about this idea of the colors of the real listening. So when you hear the recording, it's for sure very different. So how is the perspective of hearing the colors when you have the recording?
Yeah, but the thing is that colors are completely, this is something I yes. would like to explain, the color, you know, I see the music in colors.
In colors.
And then the thing that not all the music I see in colors, that should be some, you know, specific mm-hmm. type. This is just, you know,
the synesthesia, right? The synesthesia.
Yeah, that Ivona Lindstedt, Professor Ivona Lindstedt,
musicologist, right, famous, yeah. Yes.
The University of Warsaw in Poland. She actually wrote the article to the Musicology Today, and this is the article.
Extract. Aha, this is the article in English. Oh, wonderful.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Between Heart and Mind, the Music of Arta Prashinska, and this is he spending, you know, some the paragraph on my, how I see the music in colors. So the music in colors, you know, the some construction, like harmonic construction, evokes some colors in my mind.
Mm-hmm,
but
mm-hmm.
It's reverse also, that when I see some chosen pieces, like chosen paintings, several of the paintings actually evoke from me, for me, the music. So it's reverse. So it's both ways of the, from the music evokes colors and colors evokes music also. So the thing is actually that not all pieces, not all paintings evoke I see in colors, but especially the painting of surrealist, impressionist, and the contemporary painting, you know, mainly. But the painting Baroque and Renaissance does not have any sound in me. You know?
Yes, that's great. But when you have the recording, is it the same or is it different? Can you see the different colors? Probably the shade might be different. When you have the same...
not the same, because mainly what is the music, the color, what I see, it's harmonic. I have the harmonic harmonic vision of the color. So then when I hear the one single sound, for example, I don't have any vision of the color.
Yes, I completely understand. I know what you are talking, about it. Because then you have the mixtures, actually, of the, when you have harmony.
It should be harmonic and should be also the timbre. The timbre. And the same chord play, for example, by the woodwind and the same chord play by the strings have slightly different color.
For but the same chord that you can hear of your music in the concert hall, the same chord, and the same chord here later on the recording, is it the same?
Yeah, it's the same color, but it's very flat on the
Okay.
It's much more like faded.
Because I saw some artists, they also say it's different shade. It's maybe very similar, but it's never the same exactly. The
different shade, different color, but also the color, it's not really clear. It's like faded color.
Faded. Doesn't have space, or I would say like that's.
I still can hear the colors. I still can hear the colors.
Yes, from the recordings. That's wonderful. And now also I would like to ask you the other thing, because you are a professor for so many years. And now during this time, are you also teaching maybe online? Do you have some students or?
No, the thing is that recently I was thinking, you know, someone was asking me, how many years did you teach?
Yes.
So I started to think about that. And then I found that I started to teach at the primary school of music in Włochy, in the district of Warsaw, when I live, you know, in Warsaw. And the district in that school in 65. So then I was also in the teaching at assistant professor at the academy, at this higher school of music in Warsaw. Then in 73, I started to teach in Bennington College. Then I was teaching in the exact order. Bennington College, then I was teaching at the University of California, Berkeley. Was teaching at College Conservatory in Cincinnati. Then I was teaching University of California in Santa Barbara. Then I was teaching in Indiana University in Bloomington twice, because it was in the 80s and then in the 90s, you know, just twice I was there. And then in Northwestern University, and then finally at the University of Chicago for 20 years. So Chicago, I was there for exactly 20 years.
Well, yes. Congratulations, this is a huge achievement. Yeah. You had so many students,
so many
international students, composers, right? But now, currently, so you don't have students that you, like, on Zoom, maybe you check some scores?
I still have, you know, the thing is that even my students who are not right now graduated and they receive the PhD diplomas, the doctoral diploma, they stay in touch with me. We created like a big family, and they usually, they are so great, you know, so that the thing is that the students very often ask me for the recommendation, this and this. So I'm still writing recommendation for the students. They sending me the composition to look to, you know, to give them comments, etc. So it's just like, you know, still it's, and then one student who is at the University of Chicago is graduating this spring, and he also sending me the composition, and then, you know, I have ideas to guide them where to send the piece for performance, etc. So it's, though it's I am just online, but we are just like going regular way, you know.
So how do you find like checking the score, like online, something like conversation?
Oh yeah, they, you know, this is, you know, even before the pandemic, the pandemic, that was the everybody was sending the score, you know, on and PDF.
PDF.
And then, you know, I'm printing and looking, and then we can, you know, online go and see the score. So it's just the same.
The same way. So that nothing changed that much in this matter. Yeah. By the way, one of your students, Rodrigo Bossart, so who was a student at the University of Chicago, she got actually first prize of the competition of saxophone for this year on the New Vision in Chopin and Friends Festival. Wonderful piece that will be performed online, because this year it was online happening, but yeah, but he got the first prize.
I love him, you know, he's so good, such a good composer. Fantastic.
Yes, yes, he got
the first. I have the luck to have a very good people, you know, just fantastic, because my students are right now professors at many international, very prestigious schools of music. Chen Yao, what I like him very much, Chen Yao, Chinese, he is the professor of composition at the Beijing Conservatory, which is the number one in China, very much. Ja Gu Lee, who is Korean, South Korean, fantastic composer. Even he was considered as the best composer at the time he was at the the University of Chicago. He is right now the professor in Seoul Conservatory.
The national.
And Krzysztof Wołek is professor at the Louisville Louisville University. Yes. And then Füsun Köksal, Turkish woman, she is the professor right now at the Izmir University in Izmir, in Turkey. And I can actually go on and on with this.
Of course.
So it's just, you know, yeah, lot of good people, and they all stay with me, and we have contact with, so this is very nice, actually.
That's great. Yeah. You know, and now I also want to ask you something that's actually not my question, but actually I mentioned about this festival Chopin Friends when I'm artist director, but it was founded by Marian Jacques, the choreographer here in New York City, who was doing actually choreography for your music Moonflowers.
Yeah.
And I have a question actually also for from him. So when when you are writing music, are you also thinking about the gestures and about some movements that later the dancer can do it? Is it associated with the physical body movement? That's the question.
Yeah. You know, the thing is that in my music, I mainly take care about dramaturgy. For me, the most important in the piece is dramaturgy. All the dramaturgy we can find even in the small piece of Chopin. Always there is dramaturgy there.
Yes.
And has to be dramaturgy, because without that, it's like, you know, sand, it's just falling apart. So dramaturgy is the structure. And the form also very important, though the structure is keeping all these elements together. So that's why, you know, they, for the ballet, it's very important to have the structure, because they, if they hear the music, they don't know how, what to do with that, right? Mm-hmm. But if the piece has the structure, has the dramaturgy, and has the shape, then the dancer can actually create something on stage.
So in this way, from dramaturgy it comes, then they can create story. Right. Yes, that's great. But you mentioned, I can, another question also about the Chopin. I would like to ask you, for you, Chopin is of course important composer, but sometimes I feel for many modern composers neglected. They find that a little old-fashioned and they don't find inspiration, but I still think we can find a lot of new great things for inspiration for the 21st music in his works, of course for piano, but also it's, we can think broadly for all the music, also for orchestra. So what is Chopin for you? And if you can find...
No, Chopin is the genius without any repetition. That's, there will be no another Chopin again. You know, this is just, you know, the one Chopin in our civilization. It's absolutely great. You know, the thing is that Chopin music has such a fantastic, he was the composer with the greatest intuition. And then the thing is that his music has light, which I am very much also, you know,
aware of, and
I also care very much and very much influenced by the Chopin light in music. The Chopin music has light because has dark moments, has light moments, has something like, you know, like is living. This is the music who is alive, the music who is not written. And this is the kind of thing that you write the music and someone perform and that's it. You know, I give you an excellent example. When as a percussionist in the 60s, I play a lot of music by the new avant-garde composers. That was the age of avant-garde with the great, you know, new ideas in music, with the new sonorities, everything we know was, and everybody was almost writing for percussion because percussion has a great possibilities of new sonorities. So then I played that. And you know what? This is something that I will tell everyone what happened. Just last summer, when I was right now in my house in Warsaw, I decided to clean because of the pandemic. I was not going out to meet my friends. So I decided to actually make an order with my music and clean, you know, the library and all my stuff and all my music. So then the notes, and then what I found suddenly, I opened the drawer and I find the pieces for percussion that I play. And then I look at that and I said, the composer, I don't recognize the name. I don't even know that I played it. I forgot completely. Then this name, the composer like that. I said, is the composer like that? I don't remember the composer like that, you know, and was performed at the Warsaw Autumn Festival, you know. So that means that there is the kind of thing that Chopin music has the light, has the inspiration, the music like coming from God, which is always, always present and always contemporary, because Chopin, it's always, everybody loves Chopin, you know. And then the music like I play at the Warsaw Autumn Festival with the composers, they had one performance and nobody remembers because the music was dead. They didn't have anything inside that, you know.
That's great. But you composed this wonderful opera. I was, I think it was 2010, right? As I was still in
there
Krakow.
There was the commission from the National Institute of Chopin, Frederick Chopin National Institute in Warsaw for the 200th anniversary of Chopin. So then what I did, actually, I always was thinking about to write opera on Chopin in Majorca, because for me, that was this sound, this whole story, it's incredible. And then I found fantastic drama written by Janusz Krasny-Krasiński. And that was exactly like, you know, I didn't need to make the libretto, because that was the libretto, this drama was, or already libretto. So I wrote that for the Chopin in Majorca. And it was the most fascinating production in the Teatr Wielki, it's the opera theater in Łódź.
Łódź,
and that was remarkable, fantastic production was. And then was always, I was fascinated. And the thing is that all the critics actually stressed very much that it's amazing that in that opera, that everybody would expect that I will quote a lot of Chopin music. Mm-hmm. There was no one quote of Chopin music in the opera that. About Chopin, but the music was very Chopin-like, you know, because has the this light that coming, you know, for the from God, you know. And then the other thing is that the only quotation which I use for the Chopin opera, in the Chopin opera, is the Bach fugue that Chopin play for himself, because he loved Bach and he played Bach when he was angry or some, you know, distressed. So he played Bach. So the Bach is the only quotation in this opera.
Yeah, that's very great. But that wasn't a first piece that you ever referred to. I also found the piece of composed Fanfare in memoriam of Frédéric Chopin many years ago.
Fanfare Chopin. It was a commission for the anniversary, and the performance was with the Chicago Hall.
Symphony Orchestra.
Yeah.
In this piece also, you didn't use any quote, right? In this piece of this Fanfare.
No, everything
was without the quote.
Everywhere, but the harmony, the harmonic construction is very Chopin-like.
So do you think about, because Chopin had his own harmonies of the chords, we call it sometimes the Chopin chord, which is the six, right?
But it's not only. It's difficult to right now to explain this in a couple of words, you know, but this is the whole thinking, you know, like, the harmonic thinking of Chopin is amazing.
That's great. So Chopin is always, I'm so glad to hear that, that you're so important. You know, we don't have many Chopin composition competitions. We have a lot of like Szymanowski, Ludovsky, right. But Chopin, do you know why? Know,
the thing is that I wrote in 2 years ago, I wrote the double concerto for cello and piano for the Krakow duo. Uh-huh. And that was the Krakow duo is the cello and piano. For the cello and piano, and for the orchestra, Krakow Orchestra performed.
Yes, I remember. Yes.
Yeah, with Paweł Kapuła conducting, and you know the thing is that in that concerto, it's also the situation was that I actually wanted very much to present to introduce, because when you have piano. It's immediately I hear Chopin. So I introduced, you know, some kind of a slightly, you know, slightly decorative motivic ideas in Chopin. And you know, that was actually the critics in Krakow came to me and said, "You are so wonderful. We heard this Chopin in your piano, but it was so unusual. They loved this because it was not like the regular quote, but that was in the harmonic construction, something that was similar. It was not the quote, but was similar.
But do you think, why don't we have the Chopin composition competition? Because we don't have, right? We have Lutosławski, Szymanowski.
Right, we don't have. I don't know why, because we should have the Chopin competition.
Yes, I was thinking about this, you know. Here we have the Chopin
composition competition, right?
Yes, because we don't have in Poland. People ask him this many times.
For piano, it could be for duo piano, though Chopin didn't write for duo piano, but it could be for duo piano in large, you know. It could be for cello and piano.
Piano and orchestra.
Voice and piano.
Yes.
Voice and piano.
Yes. Or piano and orchestra also possible.
Piano, orchestra, right.
Piano and orchestra because of his concertos, right?
Right.
Yes.
Right.
Yes, we don't have, you know, this Chopin and Friends Festival that we have here as a Chopin's a grandfather here in New York. We have this composition competition, which somehow also refers, some composer can refer to Chopin, but this is not a Chopin competition.
It will be great to have the Chopin competition.
I know.
Different categories.
Yes, many people ask about this, many composers, yes, because every composer, great composer, has his own, like in Korea, they have Isangyun or so many, but Chopin doesn't have his only piano composition.
When you listen to Chopin, even whatever you pick up, just doesn't matter, you know. For example, the ballad, or four impromptus. You know, when you pick up this four impromptus, how many colors are there? How many things are happening there? What a kind of a narration? What a dramaturgy is there? So this is like, you know, the one impromptu, it's like a big book, you know, like the story is there, you know, so it's just fascinating very much.
It's just fascinating.
And the things that are, they are not passing, they are just, that will stay forever, you know, that's the thing.
Eternal.
But the new sounds, pick, pock, 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 that will pass out, you know, because someone said, okay, I know this sound, I don't need them to hear again.
Mm-hmm. Of course, of course. Yeah. But in the context, maybe sometimes, you know, it's always, always the past.
Context, like my music, I love this sound sonorities. I love this sort of the new sonorities because I grew up on also Otymfesty, on the music of the avant-garde. So I love that. And, you know, I am incorporating that all the kind of a very interesting sonorities within my structure, within the dramaturgy, my dramaturgy. So then the people even don't hear that, they hear so many new sonorities because they hear the pace of the action, but they don't hear that something, but they hear that this is something happening in this moment and it's interesting. So that should be like that.
Not points, you are actually now mentioning this paper means the points, right? Pointillistic music.
But this is the kind of thing that it serves for something. It just has the meaning for something else, not only for that I know this effect, for example.
Yes, yes. Yeah. And are you planning to go to Poland also soon? Or also, what are your plans for artistic creation?
The plans, yeah. I plan to go in April and then stay, you know, probably I will stay to the end of, definitely to the end of October, but maybe even November, because October I have the premiere of the Concerto for Accordion with Claudius
Barra.
And that will be October, is already set, or October 17 by the Polish Radio Orchestra in Warsaw. And Klaus, the conductor, Klaus will conduct this. And Claudius Baran will play the concerto. So
that's great. But the concerto is already finished, right? You finished.
Yes, finished.
It's completely finished. How many movements? Two movements.
And the concerto for double concerto, which I wrote for Krakow Duo, for Schlezer Kalinowski, had four movements. It was a big concerto. And this is two movements.
You like to write, and you have a lot of concertos in your output of work, but what is concerto?
The next concerto will be coming. It's double concerto again, saxophone and piano.
Oh, saxophone. So what is concerto, right, when you write concertos?
It's solo instrument with the orchestra. And orchestra can vary, you know, just depending, you know, of the, it could be the large orchestra. I don't like to write the large orchestra for the concerto structure, because concerto usually is a soloist. So soloist, I don't want to have the soloist fight with the big body of sonority, you know, of the orchestra. So usually chamber orchestra, or this even smaller, like for the accordion, I wrote the accordion concerto with the small chamber ensemble orchestra. So it's the harp, three percussionists, and strings only.
No woodwind. Mm-hmm. Interesting combination.
Yeah.
But do you have dream? Maybe also, if you are talking concerto, do you have any dream that you would like to write for instrument that you've never written before, concerto? Do you have some special dreams of writing?
Of writing
for a special maybe instrument. Do you have such dreams? Maybe I don't know. Maybe ney or something like a saw or like
theremin.
Really? You would like to love concerto for theremin?
No, I'm just, yeah.
I'm joking. Oh, okay.
I said maybe theremin.
Theremin.
I like the instruments which I really very well know. You know, the concerto is virtuoso presentation of the soloist and instrument. So I really like to have the concerto which is written for the instrument I really know well. You know.
But you don't have your favorite instrument also. You don't have your favorite.
Some instruments I will never write concerto because I don't feel that I will be able to write. Mm-hmm. Like, for example, the concerto for trombone or concerto for tuba. I was asked when I was teaching at Indiana University, it's a very strong department of tuba. They have the strongest department of tuba in the entire country. And they were asking me to write concerto because they only have one concerto, Williams concerto for tuba. And now no one wrote any other concerto for tuba. So and they asked me, but I just don't feel like, you know, that I don't have my strength in that instrument, actually.
Mm-hmm. I see, but have you written many pieces for the wind orchestra, so popular in the States, wind ensembles with orchestras?
Right, yeah.
You do that, you like to write for this kind of ensemble.
Yeah, for the, right, yeah, but by mainly I write the all combination of the classical orchestra, symphony orchestra.
So, yeah. Professor, we wish you all those great energy for another upcoming premieres and another pieces, wonderful pieces, another concertos, and a lot of fascination. So in this time, good travel also to Poland without any problems, yes, and having
much.
A great time also this heresy in Florida.
Thank you very
and
much.
Thank you very much for this conversation, for sharing with us. We are at the end now. We play this your recent work. Movement, second movement from the extract from the second movement or the second flute concert.
Okay? Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor, very much. Thank you. Have a great day. Bye bye.
Thank you. Bye.